Welcome to Raw is Jericho! Tonight, because tonight, Y2J is the general manager of Raw! And on top of that, we have the lovely Raw Divas coming out for the first ever Chris Jericho Rock and Roll Limbo A Go-Go with music provided by my band, Fozzy! Yes! But before the party can start, I want you guys to check out the Jerichon 5000 and let's watch the controversial ending to last week's Triple Threat Championship match between Edge, Chris Benoit, and Triple H. Roll the clip, monkeys. There it is. There's another angle. Let's see what happened. Let's try it from the reverse. Let's try another angle. Look at this one. I don't know. Well, as you can see, we don't know who the real world champion is, and it's a question that not even the general manager can answer. As a matter of fact, only one man is as wise with the decision-making power to decide what's gonna happen. Ladies and gentlemen, my guest on the highlight reel, the chairman of the board of the WWE, Vincent Kennedy McMahon!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, let us officially welcome you to Monday Night Raw. Jim Ross and Jerry the King Lawler and a native North Carolinian, Mr. McMahon, making his way to the ring. And he's the only guy I know that can hear this controversy up, King. Who is the world's heavyweight champion? Is it Chris Benoit or is it Edge?
Well, I think we're about to find out. There's, you know what? Actually, that world championship title looks pretty good on Mr. McMahon, doesn't it? Oh. And you can just declare himself the world champion.
All right. Well, it seems like everyone has reviewed the footage.
Give us the answer, Vince. Who's the champion? We need to know.
Well, it's pretty obvious to me after reviewing the footage. Chris Benoit's shoulders were clearly down for a count of three.
Wow.
It was also obvious to me that Edge tapped out.
He did that.
As a matter of fact, Edge tapped out at exactly the same time that Chris Benoit's shoulders were counted down to three. So I would suggest then what we would have, traditionally speaking, is we'd probably have ourselves a tie.
Tie?
Yeah, I don't like ties either. Maybe it's not a tie, but seems to me, traditionally speaking, whenever you have two contenders who sort of cancel each other out, neither one of them would normally be named the World Heavyweight Champion. Therefore,
it's all about the game.
Therefore, well, here comes Triple H. A man who came on Raw last week as the World Heavyweight Champion, but Mr. McMahon was trying to say that if both contenders were eliminating each other, I don't know exactly what we got here.
Well, maybe it's, you ever heard the expression, one tie, all tie. I'm just kind of looking at this, looks like a little smile on the face of Triple H. Maybe he's seeming that things are going to go his way here.
And maybe he knows something that we don't know.
Triple H is smiling. Mr. McMahon is smiling. They are.
You know I don't like being interrupted, you know that. But quite frankly, I think I have really only one word that's appropriate for you right now. And that would be, congratulations.
Oh! There you have it.
Look at this!
Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen, because you're looking at a best-selling author. There's no doubt about that.
Best-selling author?
Yes, indeed. Tomorrow, at bookstores everywhere, The Making of the Game. It's a must-read for anyone who's in the physical fitness. Yeah. But I know that's not why you're out here. So, again, though, congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, Triple H is a certifiable movie star because... Yes, that's right.
Movie star.
This Wednesday, theaters all over North America, Ryan Reynolds, Jessica Biel, and Triple H, along with Wesley Snipes, star in Blade Trinity. And that is an ass-kicking film. I've seen it. Congratulations.
Whoa, I think, what? Wait a minute.
Excuse me. I don't think I named you world champion.
Uh-oh.
Did I name you world champion? You came out here and interrupted me. Did I name you world champion? I don't think I named anybody world champion. And you know what? I'm not going to name anybody world champion.
Wait a minute.
What? I'm not going to get involved in this championship mess. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to dump that right in Eric Bischoff's lap when he returns next week. Bischoff, whether he likes it or not, is going to have to make this decision. But I'll tell you what I will do. I'll make a decision tonight. As far as I'm concerned, this World Heavyweight Championship is vacated, which means one thing. As of this moment, you are no longer the World Heavyweight Champion.
My gosh!
Wow!
Vacated. That is the one thing Triple H never wanted to hear.
Mr. McMahon, who knows Eric Bischoff will be back from vacation next week, is leaving this monumental decision up to Bischoff.
Oh. Look at the look on Triple H's face. He is steaming.
The World Heavyweight Championship officially vacated by order of the chairman of the WWE, Mr. McMahon.
Wow. We have no world champion, but one thing we do know for sure, Triple H is no longer the World Heavyweight Champion.
What else is going to happen tonight? The world title has been vacated.
Nobody beat me. I should still be the world champion.
It's ridiculous. I don't know what McMahon's talking about.
This whole thing is bull.
Calm down, man. Jesus Christ.
Well, and then that's as mad as you get? Huh? Are you just going to stand there looking
I'm
like
mad,
that?
I'm mad, man. I just express it in different ways.
Oh, you express it in different ways, huh?
Yeah.
I guess it was a different way you were expressing your anger last week when Orton threw you out. How you just shrugged your shoulders and walk off with a big smile on your face, huh? Is that how you show your anger?
Look. In case you didn't realize it, it was me running down there to save your ass. And in case you didn't realize it, it was me pulling Benoit out of that crossface. And in case you didn't realize it, if it wasn't for me, there'd be no controversy. Chris Benoit would be world champion, period. You're welcome. Don't.
Thank you!
Don't.